You've probably seen AI images like these, or OpenAI's incredible AI video generator, Sora. But how are these AI images made? The algorithm behind them is called diffusion, and the basic idea is surprisingly simple. Here it is. To make an AI that can create brand new images, all you have to do is train an AI that gets good at denoising images. Here's why. Let's start with this picture of my beautiful German Shepherd and add a bit of noise to it. There are plenty of images like this online, and you can add any amount of noise that you want to them. But now let's suppose we get an AI to learn how to fix any image like this. It only gets access to the noisy version, and it needs to zoom in and fix the pixels that are off. After it's done, we can judge it against the original image. If it made mistakes, these are pointed out, and the AI learns to do better next time. If you're training the AI on lots and lots of images on the internet, eventually it'll get pretty good at taking even very noisy images and squinting and recovering the actual image underneath. Now, let's suppose that we trick this AI. We give it an image with pure noise. There is no actual image underneath. What's it going to do? Well, it'll look at it, squint, and then imagine that it actually can see something, and it'll recover that image from the noise. This is actually a brand new image. The AI has hallucinated it from pure noise. But why isn't this just a random mess then? Because the AI has learned when it was denoising to expect certain things from an image. It learned that nearby pixels are usually a similar color. It learned that usually there is some sort of ground in the image and everything else sits on it. It learned that people love to take thousands of images of their dogs, you know? So it's expecting those sorts of features. And so it imagines that it does see them, even in pure noise. So there you go. You've made an AI now that makes new plausible images from nothing. But this isn't that helpful. You don't want a random image. You want to give it a prompt, like a pink poodle jumping with a rainbow behind it, and you want it to make that image. So for this, we need to go back to the start and train a slightly different denoising AI, one that takes hints. Many images online have some sort of text label, either in the alt text or nearby as a caption. For example, this image might have the label, "A cockapoo puppy's first birthday gone wrong." Let's add noise to it and give it to the AI model like before and ask it to denoise it. But now we're going to do it a huge favor. We're going to let it have the text description too. Imagine how much easier this is with the text prompt. Now the AI can look at this noise and it'll think, this is probably the cockapoo's legs. And this here, that's probably a balloon one since it's her first birthday. And gone wrong, well, something's definitely gone wrong with the face area of this puppy. Ah, it must be a party hat falling off. And so the hint really guides the AI in what it ultimately sees in the noise. This new AI that you've trained is still a denoiser, but it's one that only works with hints. So in a way, it's a worse denoiser than the previous one, but actually, it's a much more helpful one for what we actually want. Like before, let's give it pure noise, but now let's give it a hint as well. How about a close-up of a golden retriever smiling? Well, the AI thinks, if I really squint, I think I can see that golden retriever right there with a typical goofy golden retriever smile. And so it makes it happen. And there you go, a brand new image of exactly what you wanted. That is the main idea. But if you've learnt about diffusion before, though, you're probably not convinced. Isn't it critical that the algorithm has like a UNet and uses a clip embedding and all of that stuff? I'd argue that no, those things aren't actually critical. In fact, modern diffusion algorithms can look very, very different in how they're implemented, but they're all tied together by a few simple ideas, and that's what we're going to talk about next. But first, let's talk about the implications of this kind of tech. If you train a model with no guardrails, then you can ask it to make whatever image you want. Like, make me an image of Donald Trump being arrested that looks so real it goes viral. fake images like this one are probably going to become a very big deal in misinformation campaigns soon, which is why it's so important to think critically about the news you read and the sources of your information. That's where Ground News, the sponsor of this video, come in. Ground News is a platform created by a former NASA engineer that lets you see and compare all sources reporting on a given story so you can verify how reliable the information is. Not only that, they show you if those sources have a political bias. Here's a really relevant story about how OpenAI found its products are already being used to create misinformation meant to sway voters. On Ground News, I can see that there were more than 60 sources reporting on this, and most of them were highly reliable. However, less than 10% of the coverage came from right-leaning sources, which means that right-leaning viewers may have missed this very important story. And there are other stories that left-leaning readers might have missed too. Ground News breaks this all down in their blind spot feed, which highlights stories that are receiving lopsided coverage from one side of the political spectrum. Ground News is a really powerful tool for making sure that you're seeing the bigger picture. If you want to check them out, go to ground.news/universe to get 40% off the unlimited Vantage plan, which is what I use. They are subscriber supported, so by signing up, you directly support the development of their platform, which is on a mission to make the media landscape more transparent. Thank you to Ground News for sponsoring this video. Okay, back to how we actually make the diffusion algorithm itself. Remember we said that there are two critical bits to a diffusion algorithm. One is having a denoising network, and the other is having prompts. For both of those things, you can make a lot of different choices. First, you get to choose what the denoiser is made of. Originally, these tended to be a type of neural network called a UNet. This is just a neural network architecture, but I'm not going to go into exactly how it works because, to be honest, they've kind of been superseded. But anyway, let's imagine that you have something in there like a UNet. An important detail I glossed over before is that our denoiser doesn't directly take a noisy image and in one pass create a denoise version. Instead, each time you use it, you get a slightly less noisy image. You can keep doing that over and over again until you get something good. These are some examples from Jeremy Howard's Fast.ai course, which is excellent. But why can't you just train an AI that goes straight from the noisy image to the final one? Well, you just can't get good results that way. Algorithmic Simplicity has a great video explaining why not at a theoretical level, so I recommend that. There are two other things in the original diffusion algorithm worth highlighting though. One is just a computational efficiency thing. Instead of feeding in the actual, potentially very big image, you can send in a compressed version called a latent. Then all the processing in the model happens on the latents themselves, which are much smaller. This isn't necessary, but it is a bit more efficient. The other thing you can do, which is very helpful, is to process the hints a bit before they go into the model. Technically, you could just input a string directly. However, then your model has to learn a lot about text as well as images. That is what some multimodal LLMs do, but maybe we want something a little bit simpler than that. Instead, we could pre-process the text first ourselves, and then output a more useful hint to the diffusion algorithm. Traditionally, this is done using a CLIP algorithm, which makes sure text prompts are already processed for visual similarity. For example, the prompt, "dog with blonde medium-length hair" and "golden retriever" will be processed to a similar output. That's helpful because as text, these two strings are very different, even though the output we want ultimately is very similar. So this prompt processing gives the algorithm a helping hand. I'd say that having some sort of prompt processing and some sort of denoising algorithm are the two crucial things for a diffusion algorithm, but you can make very different choices about how you do these two things. In fact, let's look at this paper that made some waves when it came out. It asks, why not replace these UNet things and put in transformers? I mean, it seems obvious, right? Transformers are powerful and scalable, and they're also so much better at paying attention over long distances, so you're less likely to get a person with six fingers. And you can see that these pictures they have in the paper are pretty much perfect. Well, except for the one with the husky's creepy eyes. Anyway, besides just putting transformers into the denoiser, they also use the prompt in a slightly different way too, which is probably better. They essentially do cross attention, which means that the image processing doesn't just pay attention to itself and how many limbs it's got. It also pays attention to the prompt, making it more likely to make an image of what you asked it to make an image of. Stable Diffusion 3 and Sora both use transformers in their networks, and you can see how incredible those results look. As long as there is a denoiser and something that processes prompts, it's a diffusion algorithm. Those two ingredients are all you need. By the way, most of this video was a deepfake of me, so I hope you can figure out which bits are the real me and which bits are AI. See you later.